Are you looking for real peace and happiness? Well, most people are, and they continue to do so. You know, in our consumer-driven age, when the social and economic order just encourages the acquisition of goods and services, and those in ever-increasing amounts, all too many people find their desires continually increasing, while their happiness is proportionately decreasing, and it is. People are even trying to buy happiness, one happiness book or one happiness pill at a time. But the result remains the same, still unhappy and driven to slavery by insatiable desires. What to do? Okay, for a change, let's turn to the timeless teachings of the Bhagavad Gita, the undisputed handbook of yoga, which guides us to learn from the example of the ocean. Krishna says, and now this is in Sanskrit, Puryamanam achala pratishtam samudramapa pravashanti jadvat tadvat kama diad pravashanti sarve sashanti mapnoti nakama kami. Translation: a person who's not disturbed by the incessant flow of desires that enter like rivers into the ocean, which is ever being filled but is always still, can alone achieve peace, and not the person who strives to satisfy such desires. Now just see the countless rivers that ever enter the ocean, which is always being filled, but always remains calm, always remaining the same, steady. It never crosses beyond the limit of its shores. It's peaceful. Similarly, if we remain undisturbed by the flow of desires, desires that inevitably accompany our body and mind, then like the ocean into which countless rivers empty, we can achieve real peace. How do we remain undisturbed like the ocean? Here are three takeaways from the Bhagavad Gita. Number one, have a clear spiritual vision of where you're going in life and the spiritual values by which you're going to get there. Make your life a quest for the eternal and not for the temporary. In short, be anchored in all your activities to spiritual strength. Number two, live by what you need and not by what you want. Depend on the Supreme to fulfill your desires for the necessities of life, for the basics. In other words, keep it simple. And number three, remain satisfied within. Be satisfied when you get what you need. Don't try to compete with your neighbors, and don't be a slave to every internet influencer. Be satisfied by fulfilling your spiritual aspirations, self-realization. Now, you may well ask, well, where does the inspiration to follow these three takeaways come from? And my answer is from the steady intelligence that you will get from studying and contemplating the eternal truths of this handbook of yoga, the Bhagavad Gita. Don't be like those restless and unhappy people who are vassals to never-ending desires. Follow the example of the ocean, and then you will learn real peace and happiness.